gonna slow us down a little bit. But next update, we should have it pretty much all taken care of. Excuse me, sir. I'm gonna walk around the back of you right now. Fuck you! And now we're all of a sudden up to 30 frames per second. That's weird. I'm using Fraps, by the way, to record all this. It's another excellent program, which I highly recommend to any Let's Player out there who wants, or any, you know, want to be a Let's Player like me. It really is. I usually use Audacity, but just because my system was slowing down so god-awfully much, I was just like, you know, fuck it, I'll record the audio through Fraps too, and that's pretty much what we got, you know? It's a fort, apparently. We're apparently in some sort of fort, which makes sense. Exclamation question mark? Now you're talking like Australian Southern? Because I've never heard a Southerner say mate. I'm just going to throw that out there. Computer, why you no work? I think someone's on the door. On the door, on the other side of the door. Get dead? Really? Oh my god. Surge is Ted Bundy. I apologize if the commentary sounds like shit as well. I'm using a Turtle Beach Air Force Z1 headset, but I have the tendency to put the mic all the way up to my mouth and speak like this, even though I really shouldn't. So yeah. No. I refuse. Fuck you. Dragon King Palace, Heaven, same damn thing. Also, fun fact, I just got over pneumonia. Whatever. You're probably right. It probably is from the Dragon King Palace, you crazy man. And I'm going to say that so that you don't axe murder me. Squid gut pasta? Dude, that just messed up. I love how it has to add in without lifting a finger there, as if to say, you lazy prick. And oh my god, we're not slow anymore. That is amazing. You. Which, by the way, for some reason, kids in this village are rampantly searching for these Komodo dragon snails. Ooh, I have a new text message. And, they're giving them to girls as a sign of affection. I guess they're pretty. They're a fisherman village, I know that much. Sure, you can have it, kid. Actually, do that to find out a little tip here about a prospective party member's favorite foods. You also receive an element for this called Uplift, which is a yellow element, I want to say. Yes, it's Hecarim Bones. Yes, I know. I just don't do that. Sounds like my ex-girlfriend. I did not just say that. But what we can actually do to sort of to prepare for that? Is we can, go into this little restaurant here with dogs everywhere, which is a sanitary eating environment. Absolutely, I was like, Serge, bro. You gotta check in your life. I know you're into her, but leave the waitress alone. And see, if we come up here and wait for this little rat bastard to leave, we can search under the bed here and get a Hecarim Bone. Took me forever to find it. I wandered around this village for 8 hours for the first time when I played this game. That was literally like the majority of my gaming experience with this, is I was looking for a goddamn Hecarim Bone. Some bullshit. First thing we really have to do... Well, if you talk to that girl, first off, the one carrying the bag, she'll tell you about her sister, Lena, who is, you know, Serge's main squeeze. And she'll say, oh, you know, she's at the docks, or whatever. And then this dude runs into the water. Seems totally responsible and safe, let him continue diving in the ocean like that. But before we talk to Lena, because that takes a long ass time and we're running pretty low on time actually. Let's talk to this guy here. Old bastard. In all actuality, I do enjoy the sea. I really enjoy being out on the water. Here, I want you to look at this masterful hiding of foreshadowing. But just remember, Serge, don't take the sea lightly. Usually you'll find the sea to be vast, deep, full of energy, yet kind and gentle. I'm a strange one. Once it becomes angry, it can turn into the most frightening monster you've ever seen, engulfing everything. Close your eyes and prick up your ears. that's a really masterful hiding of foreshadowing. But I think that's a pretty good first little set. So I guess we're gonna leave it here. I just want to say thank you guys for tuning in, and I hope to see you again soon. I will try and update this as soon as possible, although I have to talk to Grave, the other Let's Player, in the Southern LP project to see when he can kind of update. We might just mass record him since I have the laptop all the time. But, we'll figure it out. Stay tuned for his Let's Play, and this has been episode 1 of Let's Play Chrono Cross. Thanks, guys, and I'll see you later.